Today's web sponsors are the Vosberry family in honor of the SOS small group, the Kazza family in memory of John McGraw and Ann Kessler, Donald Dyack in honor of the AV team, Daniel Crest, Andrew Gilbert, Rich Fultz, Dave Vosberry, and Joe Abadi. Norma Knoll in memory of Norman Knoll. This week's announcements, Tuesday, 11/17, the administrative board meets at 6:30 p.m. Thursday, 11/19, trustees at 6 p.m. at the church. I do believe Food Sense pickup is also Wednesday this week at 9:30, 10 a.m. And looking ahead, Thursday, 11/26, and Friday, 11/27, the office is closed. Happy Thanksgiving. Saturday, December 5th, there's a blood drive in the fellowship hall from 8 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. And that's all for today's announcements. Join me in prayer. Creator God, the earth is yours and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. We gather to worship you and sing your praise, King of glory and Lord Almighty. As we stand in your holy presence, we confess that we are not worthy to come before you because we have sinned and come short of your glory. Yet we come because our need for you is great. We need your grace and mercy, O God. We pray for clean hands and a pure heart. Forgive us for trusting in idols and swearing to false gods. We pray that we will receive your blessing, O God, our Savior. Thank you, Creator God, for this day of worship and for this time when we come together to worship you, our Maker. Renew us with your Spirit and bless us with your presence and power to live as faithful servants all our days. Amen.
Who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
To To you I lift up my eyes, O you who are enthroned in the heavens.
As the eyes of servants look to the hand of their master, as the eyes of a maid to the hand of her mistress, so our eyes look to the Lord, God, until he has mercy upon us.
Have mercy upon us, O Lord, have mercy upon us, for we have had more than enough of contempt.
Our soul has had more than its fill. The scorn of those who are ease of the contempt of the proud.
Good morning, everyone. This is Stewardship Sunday, and I just want to take this opportunity to thank everyone, and I mean everyone, that supports our church family, First United Methodist Church. It's been a very, very difficult year. Everyone knows that, with this pandemic. But we are so, so grateful to have so many people that support us, not just monetarily, but all the committees and all the boards that people are on. I mean, to mention everyone I cannot do, because it wouldn't be fair, because I forget people. But leadership is so very, very important for our congregation, and we have a great leader, no doubt about it. Yes. And we thank you, Pastor Niles, for all that you do. He's quite a humanitarian and a great person to know. But we also have great leaders on all our committees, and I'm very grateful for that. Yes, they are. But you know, when you think about our committees, you think about maybe the trustees or the SPPR, things of that nature. But we have so many other committees. You know, the Food Sense. You know, we have the Food Sense. We have the United Methodist Men. We have the small groups. We have the Education Memorial Committee, the Music Committee. These are so valuable to our success. As I said, I don't want to mention names, but I have three people I do want to mention because they're getting off and retiring. Nancy, our secretary, is fantastic, but she's giving up the bookkeeping. She does such a great job for us, absolutely phenomenal, but she's retiring. So we thank her. Yeah. Joe Abadi on our web ministry. He's giving up that position. But Andrew Gilbert is going to take his position. So we thank that. So very good. And last but not least, Dan Crast. Dan Crast is the president of the UMM, the United Methodist Men. And we thank him for that. Thank you, Dan. I have a little sore throat. I don't have anything bad, but, you know, my throat is a little dry. Now I'm going to change hats, and I'm going to talk about the finances. And I apologize for this, but it's something we have to do. Each year we have a budget that we have to go through, and it's difficult. And it's going to be very difficult this year, very, very difficult. But we do have a budget, and we try to follow this budget. But there's times we just can't meet that budget. So we have what are called fundraisers. You know, we have many fundraisers. And one of the biggest fundraisers is our golf tournament. We can't have that this year. We didn't have it. We lost thousands of dollars. The United Methodist Men have fundraisers. We couldn't have them. So we've lost all of that money. So we're making appeals. One of the things is we had this Thanksgiving offering. Everybody get this, or most everybody get one? And we're asking you if you could just consider giving for this fund. Also consider giving your weekly or monthly or yearly pledges. That would really be a big help, absolutely big help. You know, we understand that money is a difficult situation at this time, but we need your support to be able to continue to be a congregation. No doubt about it. We're behind. It takes about $3,100 a month to run this church. And if you take what we made last year at this time to what we have this year, We're behind a good amount of money. So I'm asking you, you know, if you would like, we have envelopes, right? We're going to have envelopes, and we'll have them in the office if you'd like to pick them up. We're going to do pledge cards, so hopefully you'll consider giving in 2021. We need your support, people. I mean, look at the web ministry, how wonderful this is for people out there. And you people listening to the web ministry, if you'd like to support us, we'd be so happy to do that. You can send your money into the office by, you know, through the mail, PayPal, or give it as we do each week in the offertory. Anything else? excuse me, I'm losing my throat here for some reason. But really, I thank everyone who supports us. Yes, Alan?
Envelopes. They want envelopes, right?
Didn't I say that?
Want envelopes, please contact Al Mosier or the office.
Okay, did you hear that? If you want envelopes, contact Al Mosier or the office. Pardon me? Okay, say it again. So if you want envelopes, please see Al Mosier or go to the office. So I guess that's it. I guess that's all that I have to say. So thank you. Thank you for your support. Thank you for all your time and effort. Thank you for your money. Just thank you. Amen.
We acknowledge that we are surrounded by many gifts which come from you. We thank you for blessing your for the blessings you pour out on us each day. Forgive us when we do not show our love and gratitude to you. Not as we give freely and wholeheartedly of what you have given us. We now, as we give freely, we pray that you will bless the offering we bring and bless our lives as we dedicate all that we have and are to your service. Through Jesus Christ, amen.
At this time, well, we will proceed then. Amanda, tell us what's next. Thank you.
It is now children's time. I'm with Maddie Burdick.
Great week. I think we can all agree that this year has been one of the weirdest yet. But I don't think that we really take the time to appreciate those around us who we're thankful for. So my challenge to you this week is to figure out who you're thankful for and thank them for being the person that they are. I know for myself, I'm thankful for my mentors at school, who I'm able to turn to when I need help with anything. I'm thankful for my family, who are always there for me no matter what. So I want you to figure out who you're thankful for in your lives and let them know, because that might just be the greatest part of their day. I hope you guys have a great week. Talk to you next week. Bye.
Hands together for Maddie and thank her for all that she does. This is a time in the service when we invite the children who are present to go with Maddie, and Chris is there as well, so we want to recognize him. So all the children, please go with Maddie. Give them a round of applause, please, as they go to Children's Church. Thank you. And friends, we would like to take this opportunity to present the names or the persons who have been newly appointed to serve in these positions you see on the screen. We have, as new trustees, Ryan Green and Richard Stellingworth. They're present. Please stand so we can recognize you, gentlemen. Thank you. We have as our administrative board, Carrie Shear. She's not present, but I believe she's viewing. So we want to welcome Carrie Shear on the administrative board. And then for our staff pastor parish committee, a new member, Caitlin Kaza. In fact, she's probably one of the youngest that we have serving on this committee, and we are so pleased to have her and all of them who have agreed to serve. It's never easy to recruit as many people as we need for the offices or the positions that we have. So we are always so delighted when persons agree to serve. And we thank you already for the service, even though this is for next year, but we want to thank you for even agreeing to serve. And we look forward to having you. What we are going to do now for a few moments is to look at the names of other persons on the other committees, boards, teams, etc., that will be serving in 2021. So just for a few moments, if you can direct your attention to the screens, we will see those names. Now, Nancy Nixdorf is our very faithful and dedicated secretary. She will continue as our secretary, but she used to serve as our bookkeeper, and that position is now open. She's retired from that, or retiring from that. These are the other names here. So there are many people, friends, who work behind the scenes to ensure the successful operation of the congregation. And these are the persons here. I want to say a very special thanks as well to Andrew Gilbert, who will be taking over the position that is being vacated by Joe Abati. We are so happy to have Andrew with his youth and all his skills. Thank you so much. And now, my friends, I'm going to offer a prayer of blessing for all these persons who have served. And we ask that you would continue to pray for them and support them. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Lord, in a world where most people are already busier than they would like to be, we are grateful for those who are able and willing to serve in the ministries of our congregation. We pray your special blessing on each of them as they undertake their sacred duties. Give them wisdom and health and strength for all the things they must do. Grant that all of us may support them enthusiastically as they assume their positions and respond to their leadership with joy and thanksgiving. Help us, Lord, to hold them up in our prayers and befriend them in every way we can. Let them know that we appreciate what they are doing now and will continue to do, and are grateful for the ongoing work of this congregation. Show us how to be better Christians, better stewards and servants, and to be more sensitive to others and to the ministry of this church in the world. Teach us to live as Jesus lived, and to fulfill his teachings in our daily existence. Make us an easy people to lead because we are eagerly seeking to do your will. And grant that we may love one another so much in Christ that our very existence as a church will prove redemptive in our whole community through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much. And now we have the reading for today. I'm going to ask Amanda to lead us in this reading. Please stand, my dear sisters and brothers, and you can read along.
For it is as if a man going on a journey summoned his slaves and entrusted his property to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to another 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. The one who had received the 5 talents went off at once and traded with them and made 5 more talents. In the same way, the one who had the 2 talents made 2 more talents. But the one who had received the 1 talent went off and dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those slaves came and settled accounts with them. Then the one who had received the 5 talents came forward. More talents, saying, Master, you handed over to me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more talents. His master said to him, Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master. And the one with the 2 talents also came forward, saying, Master, you handed over to me 2 talents. See, I have made 2 more talents. His master said to him, Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master. Then the one who had received the 1 talent also came forward, saying, Master, I knew that you were a harsh man, reaping where you did not sow, and gathering where you did not scatter seed. So I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here you have what is yours. But his master replied, You wicked and lazy slave, you knew, did you, that I reap where I did not sow, and gather where I did not scatter, then you ought to have invested my money with the bankers, and on my return I would have received what was my own with interest. So take the talent from him and give it to the one with the 10 talents. For to those who have, more will be given, and they will have in abundance. But from those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away. As for this worthless slave, throw him into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth.
This is the gospel of Christ. Praise be to Christ our Lord. Amen. Have a seat, please. Now let us say thanks to Amanda and Gianna for the role they played in today's service. Thank you so much. You have been faithful in a little. We will place you over much. So we look forward to having you again, Amanda. Thank you so much. Now let the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be found acceptable in your sight, O God, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. On this day, designated as our Stewardship Sunday, and as we reflect on the parable just read, we are reminded that stewardship, service, has to do with holding in trust what belongs to another, serving God who gave us life and thought and being. The parable makes this point very clearly today. The servants or the slaves were each entrusted with a portion of the master's property. It was not theirs. It belonged to their master who entrusted it to them. The parable says that the master summoned his slaves or his servants and entrusted his property to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to another 1, to each according to his ability. So the master knew the ability of each servant, and it was the master's decision what each servant would receive. So I say, my friends, that we are all stewards. We are all servants. We are all slaves of the master of all. We have varying abilities. We have all received from the master who trusts us with his own for a while. Now, I find this to be a good way to think about life, to think about our time in this world, to think about our wealth and other resources, our talents, our skills, our expertise. They are all gifts, my friends, that the master has placed in our trust or our care for a time. And it's very humbling to think about what we have in this way. And I think it is the appropriate way, the correct way to think about all that we have and all that we are. Everything we possess is a gift from God, the maker of us all. And when we think of what we have in that way, when we see ourselves as stewards, as what we have as belonging, not to us, but to God, given to us only for a time, it gives us the correct attitude when it comes to how we use what we have, how we employ what we have as we go through life. So this parable is very instructive. And it also contains a word of commendation. The master says to two of his servants or slaves, "Well done, good and trustworthy slaves. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master." So when I spoke to Amanda just now, I was quoting from the parable. So on this Stewardship Sunday, my dear friends, I want to take this opportunity to express thanks and appreciation to all of you who have done well, who have served faithfully. I want to underscore the words of our brother Tom Brown a little earlier. Thank you for your service. Thank you for your stewardship. Let me remind you, as the parable does, that the reward for service well and faithfully done is greater service. Yes, the reward for work done well is that we are called to continue to work well. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. So we look forward to the new and greater service of the faithful as we encourage others to follow their example. We recognize, my friends, that there are so many others who have not been really playing and fulfilling the role that they have been called to fulfill. And so we want to encourage others to be a part of this congregation and to help to move and advance the work of God and to promote the gospel and the kingdom through service in this congregation. So we want to say thanks to those of you who have served so well. We commend you. We congratulate you. We appreciate you. And we encourage you to continue keeping on. Now, before I close, I want to share some characteristics of faithful servants or stewards. Faithful servants make good use of every opportunity. The parable says that the man was about to take a long journey when he called his slaves or his servants together and divided his property among them. Then, after a long time, the master of those slaves returned to settle accounts with them. Now, in these parables found in the 25th chapter of the Gospel according to Matthew, there is an emphasis laid on time and opportunity. The 10 virgins had time because the bridegroom was delayed. That is the first parable we find in Matthew 25. And then in the parable of the sheep and the goats, the third parable in Matthew chapter 25, we see that the judgment is based on how people use the opportunities they have, how they respond to the needs of others, the needs that might confront them. And here in today's parable, the servants had time. The master went on a journey and was gone for a long time. After a long time, the master returned. And it was on the return of the master that the slaves were able to give an account of their stewardship. So, my dear sisters and brothers, these parables remind us of the importance of making good use of our time and our opportunities. The faithful servants use their time and the opportunity given to them in an appropriate way. The other thing about faithful servants is that they take responsibility. The servants knew that a day would come when they would have to give an account of their service or of their stewardship. How did they do with their time and the opportunity they had? They would have to answer one day. And this is something that we must all remember, that a day is going to come when we will have to answer for our stewardship. How did we use our time and our opportunities? The faithful servants took responsibility for whatever they did. They didn't blame others. They were not like the other servant who, in effect, in the parable, if you look at it, he blames his master instead of taking responsibility for himself. He says, "Master, I knew that you were a harsh man, reaping where you did not sow and gathering where you did not scatter seed. So I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground." So when we don't take responsibility, we find ourselves blaming others. Because responsibility, my friends, is the ability to respond. You're given something. You're dealt a certain hand. You face a set of circumstances. And what matters is how you respond to what you are given. So the master is pleased with those who accept responsibility and promotes those who are faithful. And the last thing that I will say about faithful servants is that they are not lazy. Faithful servants aren't lazy. In other words, faithful servants are willing to work. They're willing to try. They're prepared to make the effort. The parable says of the two servants, they traded with them. That is, they traded what they had received. They took a risk. They were willing to venture out and invest what they had. They didn't know what the future would bring, and none of us knows what the future will bring. And that is where faith comes in, my friends. But you see, fear is the opposite of faith. And when we are afraid, when we are fearful, we tend to fail in venturing out. So I want to commend the persons who have accepted to serve in the coming year. You don't know what that really means right now, but you trust God. You have faith in God, and you have taken the first step. And I believe, my sisters and brothers, that God will bless and reward your efforts. So the parable today makes a profound and important point. The servants who used what they were given, who traded with them or invested them, were able to increase what they received. And the one who hid his talent, hid what he was given for fear of losing it, we realize that what he feared most is actually what ended up happening. The thing he feared is the thing that happened. He lost what he was given. He squandered his opportunity. He squandered, wasted his master's gift because he was dominated by fear and lacked the faith to take any risk. My friends, don't let fear dominate your life. When it comes to the service of God, I want to let you know now that people will always have something to say. People will always want to criticize you, but don't be afraid of criticism. And don't be afraid to fail. Remember, my friends, that it is worse to try to fail to try than to try and fail. If you try something and you fail, that's okay. But if you fail to try to even make the effort, that is a worse position to be in. So that third servant was afraid of failure. And that attitude prevented him from even trying. He made excuses. Unfortunately, we find that people like to make excuses. And so the thing he feared is exactly what happened. So I encourage you on this Stewardship Sunday, my dear sisters and brothers, let us, by faith, do our best in the service of God with whatever God has entrusted to us. And may God bless us all today and in the future. And may we always go forward with faith and not with fear. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Friends, as we move on, we will have that video that was prepared by our choir director. Thank you very much for that. And then we will have our final prayers.
I just want to say, I feel like this song is about how God can do anything. And if we're broken, he can heal us. If there's something going on in our lives, he's going to take care of it. And he has a plan for us. And I think that's really powerful. And I think that this song really emulates that. I really like the lyrics. And I really like singing it. Even though there's a long musical interlude, I thought it was the perfect time to just thank God for all that he does for us. Tears stream down your face when you lose something you cannot replace. Tears stream down your face. I promise you I will learn from my mistakes. Tears stream down your face and I. Lights will guide you home.
Emily, I'm glad we were able to get that to work. Thank you. And we'd like to say thanks to our ushers as well. They do a fantastic job each week, especially under these circumstances. Thank you. Friends, we are coming to an end here, but I like to, acknowledge some of the messages that come in on the Facebook. Think snow, lots of snow. All right. Glenda Barty says, thanks, Tom Brown, for all that you do. Thank you, Brown, Brother Tom Brown. Linda Cohen says, nice job, Amanda and Gianna. Thank you for your leadership in the service. And Shauna Ann, thank you to everyone in leadership roles. You are truly blessings for this congregation. These are wonderful messages. Thank you so much. We continue to pray for our law enforcement officers, all other frontline responders, and the truck drivers, our farmers, those who are in nursing homes and hospitals still separated from their families. And a final prayer request for Tyler and Marty, coming from Shauna Ann. Pray for Tyler and Marty, both receiving treatment, and prayers for Everly and Eleanor Hoffman. So we keep these persons in our prayers. And you may know of others that need prayers today. So as we join in our final prayers, please bring those individuals and those concerns to mind. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. We pray today for our web sponsors, the Vosbury family, Norma Noel, Donald Dyack, and the Kaza family, giving thanks for their support of this ministry. We pray, O God, that your favor will be upon them and that you will establish the work of their hands. Thank you for their kindness and generosity. We join our web sponsors in thanking and honoring the SOS group and the AV team, Daniel Crast, Andrew Gilbert, Richard Foles, David Vosbury, and Joe Abati. O Lord, bless and surround these individuals with your favor as with a shield, and equip them as they continue in your service. We lovingly remember your departed servants, Norman Noel, John McGrath, and Ann Kassler, and rejoice that they gave themselves to you in their lifetime and in their service. And even in death, they remain precious in your sight and precious to us who knew them. We pray that they will rest in peace. We pray for the sick, those experiencing mental health and other emotional challenges, those being treated for some disease or condition. We lift up the names of those who have been given to us, Lord, Tyler and Marty, Everly and Eleanor, Mary Gardner, and others. I pause to allow you to mention names in your heart out loud if you wish. We lift up those who are disappointed and dejected, those who have addictions that hinder their ability to function at their optimum, those who feel unloved and rejected. Grant healing, assurance of your goodness, deliverance, and support to all those for whom we pray today. We pray for our country and all the nations of the world. We give thanks for the hard work that is being done to reduce the spread of and to eradicate the coronavirus pandemic. We give thanks for the development of safe and effective vaccinations and pray that that process will proceed efficiently. O God of peace, we pray that those in authority and influence will use their positions to set a good example, work for unity, and serve others, not themselves, and help to promote peace and justice. Be the refuge of those facing storms or any kind of calamity. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Amen. Our final hymn, Here I Am, Lord. Thank you. In your name, Lord God, we go forth, in your strength to be strong, in your wisdom to be wise, in your grace to find our sufficiency, in your spirit to abide in love, joy, and peace. Thine is the kingdom, O God, the power and the glory, forever and ever. May the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon us all this day and always. Amen. God bless you. Those of you who will be participating in our Thanksgiving celebration, please remain so that we can do the recording now. Thank you.